Yo guys, what is going on? Welcome to the early access gameplay of Dark Souls 3. Now, I can definitely say I was never a fan of the Dark Souls series, so I'm coming into this from a Bloodborne perspective because I loved Bloodborne. It was such an amazing game, and I'm hoping some of the fast-paced combat has made its way over into Dark Souls 3, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm playing as a thief, and I'm hoping that everything turns out the way that it needs to. Control camera with your right stick. No kidding. Let me guess. Another one. Regular attack. RB. That's going to be a lot of RBing. Alright. Strong attack. Right trigger. Is that my first enemy? Yeah, it is. First enemy indeed. And at least I can kind of tell. Backstep. Nice. Okay. Real question is, which way does it want me to go? Hello. Didn't even see him. I'm practically dead. And I just started. Got myself a flask. One of the things I need to remember is what all the controls do. Guard. Okay, so I can block, so that's a big plus. Critical hit, RB behind an enemy. I should have did the strong attack. I think that would have been the stun, if I'm not mistaken. The stun. There's so many things in this I don't remember. It's kind of sad. Backstep. Move and dash. I don't know what's the right way and what's the wrong way. Apparently I'm going... Soul of a deserted corpse. I guess I got my first soul. I'm sure Discord is just about to go crazy and announce me, which I'm totally fine with. The real question is, am I going to be able to stay alive to try and make it to a certain checkpoint? Or randomly someone's going to see me and I didn't want them to? Parry after a successful parry. Okay, so that did work. In one try. That's a shocker. I was actually able to pull something off. Now, is this going to take me back over? Oh, and it is. It's going to put me behind him. Even better. Please don't see me. Please don't see me. Please don't see me. One hit. One hit. That's all it takes. Two-handed weapon. Only two-handed use weapon skills. Oh, dude. No. You can't do that to me. At least I'd prefer if you didn't. That person's already dead. This is another way for me to go. I'm probably gonna get attacked by someone almost instantly. I can't tell what was right and what was wrong. It doesn't really say. What's going on, Ridgebird? Welcome to the stream. Thank you so much for checking everything out. Welcome to the very beginning of my Dark Souls 3 adventure. I can't tell if that's going to end something or if it's going to start something, so I'm going to go down this other pathway one more time till it ends. Hopefully it's going to put me at a dead end. I don't really know. How was your day, Ridge? Did you have a pretty decent day? I don't know, for some reason I thought it was Monday earlier today. I was completely thrown off. And there goes Discord announcing where I'm at right now. What the hell is that? I'm not gonna be able to face that. There's no way. Oh, shit. And there's my first death. Death number one. And I just started, so I can already tell how well I'm gonna play this game. I am trying to play it a lot more like I would play Bloodborne, so shame on me for that. I know this game is really about being on the defensive, but I don't know. We'll see if I can manage. I'm right back to where we started. I didn't go very far. I haven't found a lantern. I haven't done anything. Well, I'm saying lantern because that's what I'm used to. I forgot what they're called in this game. I think they're called torches or something. The real question is, are all these souls gonna still be down there? What is this game based on? Have you ever played a Dark Souls game? Ever? Basically, all it is you're gonna be dying a lot. You try and make your way from point A to point B, taking on a bunch of different enemies, some mini bosses, some big bosses, and eventually you become so good that you try and figure out what their patterns are and continue on. I'm gonna kill everyone all over again and go from there. Parry. One strike or two strikes. That's fine. See, I'm kind of getting the idea down. As long as I do the parts that are necessary to try and be on the defense, I would be good. This guy is not even gonna see me. No, yes he will. Can I pick up your crossbow? I'd like to have it if I can. Dude, just charge and attack me, why don't you? Three down, straight from the start. Alright, there's only one more path for me to take, and that was the one that I took a minute ago where I died, so I guess I could risk it and try it again. There's the souls I dropped, so I'm gonna have to try and pick these up almost immediately, or he's totally just gonna, like, screw me over. I can roll, I can dodge, bring it on. I don't know why I'm trying to take you on. I'm gonna die. Woo. Okay, wait a minute. He was kind of stunned. I'm out of good old stamina here. So I can't really attack or do anything worthy. I'm dead. Yep. Round number two, already died. Same boss, or same enemy, same whatever the hell it is. Apparently, I'm never gonna get past this guy with the stuff that I have. Stella, go lay down. I don't know why in the world you're doing that. Okay. Cemetery of Ash number 3. I'm going places. I almost killed him. So, maybe I'll actually get somewhere this time. But, I think he missed. Just saying. And you had a golden opportunity to take me down, it just didn't work out for you. One hit. And he already saw me, he's gonna shoot at me. Yep. Big surprise. At least I did manage to go and pick up those souls, so I didn't lose them. Oh, dude, you just got jabbed in the gut. That was awesome. Okay. Alright, so the combat is a little bit different than what you would come to expect from the Bloodborne series overall. But it is very, very similar, at least when I'm playing with this class. I don't know about any other class. I am playing with the Thief, and he is pretty quick. He's got just a little dagger, and so far it's working out pretty well. Just let me get my souls! Thank you! And let me roll without killing me! Please don't kill me. Ow. Alright, come and get me, buddy. Roll at me. Or lunge at me. What's going on, Carlos? Welcome to the stream. Don't touch me! And your ass is stunned. You may actually die this time. All right, come lunge at me. Do it again, roll. Roll. So that's not rolling at me. I want you to roll at me. Or pounce at me. The son of a bitch is dead. Thank you, I finally killed him for the first time. When does this game come out? It comes out on April the 12th, Jeremy. Not a moment before. And I will say this. I am playing on Xbox One. Because that's what I have it on. And the game runs at 900p. And the frames are dropping big time. I'm actually going below 30 frames per second quite often. And it's kind of sad. But that's okay. We'll make it work out. Hopefully there will be another patch between now and launch to update the frame rate issues. Because I can't imagine how bad it's going to be when there's multiple enemies on the screen. Works great. I go into work tomorrow from 9 to 6. Tomorrow's my Monday. It's a Friday, but it's a Monday. I've had 2 days off, so. Beautiful mountains. Snowy mountains. Okay, I haven't been past this part yet, so I have no idea what to expect or where I'm going. Or I think I just found my first torch. Or, yep, bonfire. I found it. There we go. Number one in the game. Bonfire lit. And first achievement. Thank you. Light a bonfire flame for the first time. There you go. There you have it. I officially have my first achievement in Dark Souls 3. It's, I can definitely... Oh, hello. How are you? Didn't see you till just now. Come and get me. Why not? Come attack me. There we go. Oh, shit. You had multiple attacks, apparently, that I was not prepared for. Ow. I'm gonna rest at the bonfire. Huh. At least it, refills health. And it apparently spawns people back in. And just like that, I was able to take him down for a second. That's like farming right there. You can easily farm right here at the beginning of the game. Thank you, guys. I kind of wish that the HUD on the left side of the screen would fade away during combat sometimes, because that would make things really interesting. Hey, Baggins, what's going on? You are not prepared. What are you talking about, Baggins? And I'm dead. At least I made it to a bonfire. I don't care. I moved on a little bit further, so I'm happy. I think this is death number 4. Hey, Candace. Yeah. That guy was the biggest, like, idiot and tool in the world. I don't know how he is in real life, but on TV it was horrible. Okay. So at least it's spawning me here. Yeah. Is he really? For what? Give me my souls. I'm not prepared for this. I'm dead again. I instantly died. Holy crap. This is not working out too well at all. Is there a way to auto-hide the HUD? I don't know. I mean, it may be an option in the settings. And if there is, it would make it a lot better. I have to check and see. Let me check the system settings here. HUD is on. Nope. Not from what I can see. If there is an option for it, I don't know where it is. I have no arrows. It's not gonna do me any good. Okay, that moment you try and parry it, an enemy and it just doesn't work. Yeah, your friend just kind of died and fell right in front of you. Sorry, guys. Give me my souls back. Mine. You can't have them. I'm gonna need them. Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot. And thank God for that parry system. I don't even know where he was hiding. Where did he come from? Okay, there's that guy. He's just kind of hanging out. There's probably someone over here waiting for me in the wings. Yep. Insta-kill. And you're just going to fire stuff at me, which is totally fine by me. You're an easy target if you do that. By the way, Baggins and Jeremy, I am in Discord if you guys want to chat. I know that we're not playing or anything, but I will definitely say to try and keep me more entertained, being able to chat with you guys would help out a lot. Alright. It looks like this is going to be a boss. I could be mistaken, but I'm probably right. He's big. He looks mean. Unless it's just a statue. I'm cool with it being a statue. Yeah, this is from Software. And they do Dark Souls. They did Bloodborne. And by removing this sword, I have a feeling something bad is about to happen. Can I have the sword? I want the sword. Give it back. Oh, shit. I woke up a beast. Oh, shit. Oh, talk about using it too late. I'm gonna die. Oh shit, he's got some major reach. Okay, why can't I parry this guy? I get that he's got a sword that's way longer than mine, but come on. I do not have another flask. I do not. Apparently, there must be a way to parry this guy at the right moment. I just don't know when to do it. Because now that my stuff is dropped over here, I don't think I'm going to be able to get it. I mean, unless I go to the bonfire and hopefully there's some stuff in there I can purchase. Apparently, I can't purchase anything. I can't do anything. I just gotta fight my way all the way back to this guy. This should be fun. Dude, come on. You're gonna go that slow? You're not even gonna try? Oh, that didn't work at all. You know, I didn't even think about trying to come over here. Why can't I get what you have? Let me jump or something. I want what that dude has. That's not fair. Dude, that was perfect. Shouldn't I get it? Oh, look at that. It's even blocked off like it would be a boss in Bloodborne. Interesting. So pretty much, the way Bloodborne was made, it was a Dark Souls complete, like, replica. Which, I'm not against. It's just, they made a whole new story. For Bloodborne, I'm gonna die from this guy. Have you played any of the other DS games? No, I have not. See, that's the thing, Jeremy. I even said this at the very start of my gameplay. I was never into the Dark Souls series. I was never really into whatever From Software had to bring to the table. Fall off the cliff. Fall off the cliff. Yeah, goodbye. Oh, shit, there's a down path? I didn't even see this. Okay, so one person can try and attack me while the other one's got a shield. This seems fair. I can dodge your attacks. And there was something waiting for me down here. Nice. Totally worth my firebomb. Yes, I need that. Okay. Okay. can't believe I still only have a crappy knife and, like, nothing else. Alright, now that I got 5 firebombs, I don't think this boss is gonna be a big challenge anymore. Can I, set this somehow? Like, to the up button? On the D-pad? That would make things so much easier. How can I make it a quick part? Wait a minute, before I make a complete ass out of myself. Maybe I just have it open and I try and kill him? I don't know. Inside the fog and I'm in a really bad spot now. Because that worked. Ow. Bastard. I'm dead. Thank you. Thank you, sir. So again, all that hard work in leaving my souls behind was for nothing. I didn't even try to go get them, so I lost everything. It's like how to play Dark Souls badly. I pretty much figured out how to do that. Don't even stand up. Thanks, bud. And goodbye. Oh, hello, another person appearing out of nowhere. I'll go and take these two on, I don't mind. If it'll give me some more firebombs, I'd be even better! Which it will not. Apparently the regenerating health thing is not a part of Bloodborne, or a part of Dark Souls that was in Bloodborne. That should have been added. That was an amazing feature and a great way to continue to trying to stay alive and restore your health without actually having to use a vial or anything. Sorry, buddy, you missed again. Okay. Pressing down on the D-pad should let you cycle through your items to get direct access to other items, like firebombs, without using a menu. Really? No. Lies. Just lets me use flasks. Nothing else. If I press up, it doesn't even let me do anything. I've got to figure this out beforehand, before I make the mistake. I don't want to make the mistake twice. I can't. I won't. I've got 30 arrows, so that's kind of nice. Boom, there we go. Quick item 4. You have to set it in the actual equipment menu. Done deal. Alright, cool. I think I'm good. Ow. on, buddy. Ow, that one actually got me. Okay. Ouch. And take the flask. Take it. No, not. Oh, that was a dumb move. I didn't want to throw fire and not take my thing again. And you totally followed me with that. Because that was fair how? Hit him in the back. Oh, shit. Yeah, I don't know what the hell he just turned into, but it's ugly as hell. And I'm dead. He's had that much health. Are you serious? Well, then. I'm pretty sure, after all that, I should be fine this time. I should be, but now I have no more firebombs, so probably not. I used them all. I think I had one left. Yep. I want to buy more firebombs, but there's like no store. Is there a place I can buy them? Ross, person in the chat. You are speaking to someone who has no Dark Souls experience. Zero, none. So, any helpful insight you can give me on trying to purchase things would be greatly appreciated. I'm a Bloodborne guy, so this is all fairly new to me. Or at least this version of what From Software has to offer. I want my souls back! Holy crap, where did you come from? Dude, you're totally gonna kill me. Alright, so now we're back at this point again, where, well, this guy can die. That worked out very nicely. You've seen some streams of Dark Souls 3 already, so without spoiling anything for you, I think you need to get past the boss before you get to the part where you can purchase stuff from NPCs. Why, thank you for that little bit of insight. Now I only wish I had more firebombs, because apparently now this is really going to make it a little bit harder, because the majority of the damage that I did to this boss was from the firebombs. So I guess I can pretty much say I'm screwed. I may have to start it over. To try and find any, anyway. Come at me, bro. That was a joke. Don't come at me. Don't come at me. I want to run to my souls. Thank you. And I'm dead. I got my souls. I'm just never gonna get past this. I had him beat. I didn't think he was gonna transform. I didn't expect it. And the moment he did, I got totally wrecked. Because just throwing that one firebomb at the end would have finished it. It would have made life so much easier. I'm going back the wrong way. By the way, for those of you who are actually watching, how many of you are pumped and excited to play Dark Souls 3? What system do you plan on playing it on? So much for the parrying idea. And did you manage to get a collector's edition or did you not get one? Thought you died! Dude! Worst Dark Souls 3 player. This guy. And we got someone speaking to me in a foreign language. Japanese? Maybe? Well, he's not speaking to me in it, but he's got a name that's in the symbols. And I'm all lost and confused on what he's trying to tell me. You bastard, die! Not this time. Wasn't gonna happen. Oh, dude! That wasn't nice. That was cruel. I'm Taiwanese. Good to know! Alright, so now how can I get on to that? Maybe if I roll. Nope. Rolling doesn't even do it. There's no climbing option. So let's just fall on this guy. I walked into it. I've dodged him every single time, but I walked into him this time. I think I'm better off falling on this guy than I am the other one. Yep. Much better choice. Only because him and his shield was really effing me up the first time. So I'm guessing music only plays whenever I get into a boss fight. Boo-hoo on that one. Alright, so the moment I go through here, I'm going to die again. I hope everyone is prepared. Acquire souls. I really don't care about what souls I have right now. Hey, bud, I'm back. Come get me. Come and get me. Oh, dude. Okay. Yep. Apparently you got the agility of a freaking beast and a half. Something that I don't have. Why mustn't I have any firebombs anymore? It helps so much. Ugh. Just think about it. How much I'm dying and struggling now compared to how much I'm gonna be dying and struggling later. It's gonna be terrible. Evil, what's going on, bud? Thanks for stopping into the early access stream of Dark Souls 3. Hopefully you had a very great day. You missed your lunge. In the back. I guess I know you won't be attacking me this time. Trying to... In the back. One hit. One hit? Yes. And where are you so I can fall on you again? For like the 50th time. I pretty much jumped off the cliff. That was lovely. Didn't work out as planned. By the way, to everyone that's currently new, be sure to go ahead and give a lovely little like to this video, and of course, sub if you enjoy what you're seeing. I'm going to have a ton of gameplay from Dark Souls 3. I'm also doing early access gameplay to Quantum Break. You're going to get more access to that stuff coming next week. And a ton of live streams. Wow, this looks and plays like Bloodborne. Ah, evil, see, that's what I would say too. But to the Dark Souls community, you would upset them. Same developer, same everything. Just, yeah. In Dark Souls 3, boss attacks seem more like combo than Dark Souls 1 and 2 boss. Alright, so you're saying they attack more in the combo style. You know, there is something on top of that wonderful casket, and I can't get to it. Has anyone seen in anyone else's streams how they were able to get whatever's on top of that coffin? If you have, please let me know. Because it would help me out a ton. And apparently that's not how you do it. Can I, like, hit the person with an arrow? I love how it looks like he's trying to pull the bow and arrow, but it's not doing anything for him. Well, there we go. You need to jump off that ledge rather than roll. I've done that. You mean just simply walk off? Or is there an actual jump? I did not mean to use that. Well, it almost seems as if I'm going to need to go back to the lovely little bonfire and start this section all over again because I wasted that. Let me just check something. I don't believe... Well, I just tried changing my jump, and apparently that didn't work. There it goes. No, it's just a simple roll. There you go. Good boy! You're such a good boy. So apparently you have to be running and then press B in order to do it. Fair enough. And I don't want to say the game would ever want to make me rage quit, but it definitely will have its moments where I just want to go, holy crap, why is this game pissing me off so much? Jump at me. Let me get my souls. It's like, thank you, Ross, for being my Dark Souls education throughout this entire section of me playing very badly. Try jumping. I want you to jump. Can you do that? I'm just a walking target being that close to you. There we go. Killed me, because he had a lovely, lovely little double hit that he was able to do there. So yay, I died again. I will not quit. I will beat this bastard. It just sucks, because it seemed like the one way I was going to beat him was through those stupid firebombs, and they're not nice enough to give them to you again. And I'm not going to go through that entire process of trying to recreate a character and start all over again. It's like, here's a question, Ross. Does stuff ever spawn back into the world when you need it most? Like, you know, firebombs. Be a big help. And I tried to parry, and I failed miserably. Alright, maybe if I actually don't land in front. That was terrible. I didn't mean to fall off. I was just trying to line myself up so I could fall on him right, and I died because of one simple mistake like that. I'm the best in the world at this game. It's like, oh, I can't wait to go ahead and post this over on my site. Be like, the first hour and a half of my Dark Souls 3 gameplay was complete BS because I died over and over and over again. I noticed the enemies don't drop very much in this game. This game really maltreats players. Damn, if you have to do all that every time you die, F that, I would be pissed. Yeah. The game can be a little mean at times, but that's also what makes the game so special. It really does give you that feeling that you did something worthy in the game. Get parried. One hit. Thank you. I'm so glad I'm getting fading souls. I never get anything but those. It's like, why don't you give me something cool? Not this time. I appreciate it, though. I'd say the drops seem lower here than Dark Souls 1 and 2, but there's a separate luck stat now. Yeah, that's true. And that other guy's already dead, so I'm not even gonna bother going that way. I'm just gonna go back to my impending doom, because I'm going to die yet again. It's going to happen. There it goes, folks. La 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 la, watch me run to my death. I don't even think I have souls in here anymore. Hey, lunge at me again. That's like the one way I'm gonna be able to kill you! Is if you actually jump at me. Like that! Ow. Take a potion! Take a potion and run for your life! Do it again. Do it again. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. I'm not doing all that much damage to you, but you know what? You're doing a lot to me. And you were totally able to hit me with that. Oh, damn. That was like useful and terrible all at the same time. Please take a flask. Run away, run away. I'm playing the cat and mouse game since I have no way to really hurt this guy. Jump at me again. Do the jump! Run! You're out of stamina. No, you're not. Use your stamina. Go! Holy shit. That was my next chance to try and take him down. Didn't really work out the way that I hoped. No! Stop doing that. Okay. Now lunge at me. Do the hop. Jump! No, don't do that one! Jump! Not running, I want you to lunge. Like, hardcore jump. Use your jumping skills. You can do it. I believe in you. There we go! Run away, run away. I basically get like 3 hits, 4 hits max, and then I gotta haul ass. And he got me good on that one. Gotta go! And he changed. He changed. Alright. I really don't know how I'm gonna kill that thing. It is an ugly bastard. Attack his ass, he's practically dead! Die, you motherfucker! Thank you! Right in front of my face, you are dead. Thank you. That only took how long? Oh. And I didn't use a single firebomb. Thank you very much. Become a host of Embers for the first time. Dude, this is like achievement galore over here. It's like, if I had emotes, I would be celebrating, but I don't have any. They don't give you any. Wait a minute. It gave me a sword. Why can't I use it? I want a sword. Give me a sword. What the hell? I just earned one. Why can't I use it? I call bullshit. This game lies. I'm gonna hit this bonfire before I forget to do so. La 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 la. I'm gonna rest now. Watch me rest. I'm resting. Yeah, that was fun. Okay, time to move on. Well, I'm at 3,200 on my souls count. The real question is how long is that gonna last? I don't know which way to go. I don't know where I'm headed. Broken straight sword. Oh, why, thank you. I'm so glad you're gonna give me a broken sword. Open menu, hit, oh, wow. Thanks for telling me that now. Dude, get over here. Walk this way. Don't wake up your buddy, though. I want to take on one of you. Ow. You prick. Dude. Seriously. How is trying to parry you not working? I got myself a lovely homeward bone. Don't know what I'm gonna do with it. I'm sure I'll use it to craft something or whatever. Anything else over here? That could have possibly... Nope, can't go that way at all. Let's not try. Maybe when I get up a little bit higher, I'm gonna find something else. And you're gonna attack me from afar. You're a bastard, you know that? Come get me, you son of a bitch. Thank you for that. Really. That was a lovely battle you tried to give me. And that route was a safe route with nothing to do at all. And there it goes. Frame rates are dropping, like hardcore. Big time frame rate issues. When you think you're going the right way and you just don't know. There's so many different paths and things for you to look at that you could easily be passing up something to pick up or anything in this game. Bunch of nothing. And we got dogs, or I don't know what the hell that was. Some type of weird beast. And the camera in this area is really starting to mess with my head. Found some ember. Don't know what it's for. I'm sure I'll figure that out at some point. I just wish I could find an NPC or a friend or something where I'm able to like do upgrades and buy stuff or whatever. Like, this isn't weird. Firelink Shrine. And there's a person down there. I can't tell if that's a bad person or not. It's not auto-locking on, so I'm guessing it's okay. Well, there's nothing over here. Nightbot couldn't tuck me in and read me at bedtime. Huh. Yeah. If it ever did that. Yeah. Say what? Is it about time? Oh, believe me, I know it is. It's midnight. I gotta be at work for 9. And I need at least 8 hours of sleep. So yeah, it's about that time. I'm just trying to get to another save point. This is one of those games where you can't save. Like, you have to find a bonfire. And that's how you save. Thank you, babe. I appreciate it. Makes my life so much easier once I actually have a decent night's sleep. Hopefully I can get one tonight. It is locked. Of course it is. And you can't jump up because it's not allowed. So I'm gonna have to go down. There's no other way for me to go. Okay, so from the little bit of this game I'm actually able to play so far, I can definitely say I like it. They, at least with this class, they've managed to somewhat match the playstyle of what Bloodborne had to offer. As long as you're good at doing defensive things, if you're not, then you suck. Hello, person.
Ah, another one roused from the sleep of death. Well, you're not alone. We unkindled are worthless. Can't even die right.
Right? You can't die for crap.
Gives me conniptions.
You just keep going back to your bonfire.
Seek the lords of Cinder and return them to their molding thrones. But we are talking true legends with the metal to link the fire. We're not fit to lick their boots.
I'm more or less a little concerned what bad things I'm gonna find while walking around this place. Like, I hear something. What the hell is that noise? Is it a weaponsmith? Is it something else? Hi, person.
Well, a newcomer, I see. I am Andre. I serve at this shrine as a humble smith forging weapons. You're in search of the Lords of Cinder, I trust. A toilsome journey, I'd wager. You'll require good arms.
Well, I hope you're able to give me something good.
Let me smith your weapons. I am a smith. Such is my purpose.
Please do. I have nothing for you,
pretty,
to repair at this point in time, my friend. It's pretty much all I got. Oh, what the hell are you doing?
A pleasure to make thine acquaintance, Ashen One. I am but a humble handmaid of the shrine.
Hey, gamer, do you think they will finally announce God of War 4 at E3? I don't want to say no to that. I mean, we all know that they've been working on a game for quite some time. They just haven't revealed anything, so I don't see why they wouldn't.
Not so charitable as to give my goods away. Ashen One, fetch souls and bring them to me. As is thy wont. No?
What do you have for me? You have all the goodies! Oh, okay. A straight sword. Does give me a hell of a lot more damage. This is gonna make things a lot more interesting. At least I have stuff I can buy from people now.
Ashen One, be sure.
I will bring you more souls, don't you worry.
Welcome to the bonfire, unkindled one. I am a fire keeper. I tend to the flame and tend to thee. The lords have left their thrones and must be delivered to them. To this end, I am at thy side. Very well. Then touch the darkness within me.
That sounds
naughty. Take nourishment
naughty.
From these sovereignless souls.
Do I think playing wizard's easier than other job? I haven't played as a wizard. I'm only playing as a thief right now. I just tried this just to see what it would be like. So, I don't know. I've leveled up my character for the very first time.
Ashen One, to be unkindled is to be a vessel for souls. Sovereignless souls will become thy strength. I will show thee how. Ashen One, bring me souls plucked from their vessels. Farewell, Ashen One. May the flames guide thee.
Well, what's so interesting... is that I'm gonna put it in there. Does that mean I now have a new bonfire? Good, thank you. I got a spot to save. I got a spot to rest. Because apparently, I don't know what else awaits me in this place. I mean, once I jump down, I don't know if there's a way out. Or what's over in this general area. There's so many people I could possibly talk to. That's from that. The real question is going to be, where do I go to get out when it's time to leave? Or do I just go back up? At least if I rest, it's going to give me... There we go! I'm going to be able to use everything here now. Or not everything, but the stuff that I have actually shows up, so... Basically, I got through the tutorial in the beginning of the game, and I'm here. I'm good. I survived after actually beating a boss after so long. And yeah, if you like what you see, hit that like button, sub if you're new, and I promise you, starting tomorrow, we're gonna get way deeper into the story than ever before. I get off at 6 p.m., and we are going to play a crap ton of Dark Souls 3. Watch it here before anywhere else. Well... there's other people that have it, but it's nice to be able to say that I have a game like this early, because it's one of those games that you can get a ton of different gameplay sessions from that are actually really interactive with the viewers, and that's what I really enjoy doing. So with that being said, I'm going to bed. I got work in the morning. I'll see you again for some more Dark Souls 3 action. Good night. Peace out.